Hi guys, so let's talk about soft classic clothing, hair, and makeup. So I have really great news. The shopping page for soft classics is up, so you could check that out and I'll leave a link down below. And the soft classic lookbook is also out, so I'll leave a link down below to that. It has 10 main looks and 15 total looks for some dressed down versions of the looks that are in italics here on this slide. So without further ado, let's get into talking about soft classics. The most common complaint I hear is that soft classics are boring and that no one talks about soft classics and that the lines don't really lend themselves very well to looking interesting or fun or sexy or anything of that nature. But I want to show you today, hopefully, that that's absolutely not true. And here we have Marion Cotillard on the left, soft classic, and Tessa Thompson on the right, flamboyant gamine. And you can see how when Marion wears this kind of animated look, Marion is in contrast, she looks a little bit boring compared to this very, very animated type of a look. But on Tessa actually looks quite elegant in this kind of very animated, very detailed look. So this might lead you to think, well, soft classics are boring. You know, they can't wear anything fun. They can't wear any checker patterns and bright things, etc. But when you take a look at when we switch the effect, so when Marion wears a very simple dress and Tessa also wears a simple dress, you can see that Tessa, flamboyant gamine, actually looks far more boring in this simple dress than Marion. Now Marion looks quite elegant and quite sophisticated, and Tessa looks like she is a tiny bit boring. Of course, neither of these ladies are boring. It is all about them using their own lines to express themselves effectively. But soft classic lines do lend themselves really well to looking really elegant, and it's pretty intuitive to look elegant as a soft classic. You can see Kirsten Dunst here, and she looks very elegant here in her soft classic lines, and maybe on the right, that's a little bit more classic, and maybe the waist emphasis could be a little yin element there to include some of her yin undercurrent. But overall, they lend themselves very well to looking elegant. But that doesn't mean that soft classics always have to be elegant. You can see that Jenna Coleman on the right here, she is soft gamine, and she looks about as elegant here, in my opinion, as Kirsten Dunst looks in her classic look. But the thing is that the way that they achieved this look is very, very different, and that's the key. And for more information on this, you guys can watch my video titled Kibbe and Personality, where I talk about how different lines create different effects on different people. You can see how different and more detailed Jenna's look is for an elegant look versus how simple and minimal Kirsten's look is to achieve the same effect. But of course, soft classics are not only elegant. They can also look very cute and girly and fun, like Kirsten looks on at the left, really quite edgy, like in the middle, and quite badass, and on the right, really quite sexy as well. So it's all about knowing how to use your own lines and working with your own body and not against it to create these kinds of different looks. And I think that soft classics actually have more flexibility to create different looks than a lot of other types do, and I'll talk about why that is later. So let's talk about soft classic lines and what is soft classic. And before we understand soft classic, we have to understand classic, the main category of soft classic. And before we understand classic, we should really understand minimal detail and what it means in terms of Kibbe body typing. So what is minimal in terms of yin and yang of the clothing? So some aspects of minimal is that the fabrics are not too stiff and they're not too lightweight. So that is not too yang and not too yin. They are not too unconstructed, but not too tight, not too stiff, and not too loose. The shapes are not too angular, not too rounded, no contrast or lack thereof, so no intense color blocking, and at the same time, no long vertical line of the same color. The lines aren't too long or too short, and of course, last but not least, minimal detail. Literally minimal detail, as well as all of these other characteristics that go into the classic look, the minimal look. So you can see that minimal detail is just one component of this very balanced look, and different textures and different shapes, even though they might look minimal, may actually not be minimal in terms of yin and yang. So let me give you guys some examples. So here we have Marion Cotillard Soft Classic wearing some primarily natural elements on the left, primarily dramatic in the middle, and primarily gamine on the right. And you can see that these are not detailed looks, but they're also not classic looks either. So that's really important to keep in mind when you're thinking about soft classic, because classic is your base type. So keep these looks in mind, and then let's contrast with an actual primarily classic dress on Marion. So here we have, first thing is literally minimal detail. The second thing is that the lines are not too long or too short, and the lines are not broken. So it's not like different colors breaking up the silhouette. And we also have a medium weight fabric, and the neckline is not too high or too low. The dress is not too tight. It's not too fitted. It's not too loose. It's not too angular. It's not too blunt. It's not too rounded. It's not too lightweight. So that is classic, right? So what happens when we add some yin, some romantic undercurrent to this minimal look? So I think of soft classic lines, and the easiest way to describe soft classic lines is like a subdued romantic type of a line. So we have a minimal base with some yin. So we have some tailoring at the cuffs, at the hem, some more lightweight fabrics, some small gathers, understated detail, some neat hair with some rounded edges. So again, a sort of understated romantic look, but keeping in mind that your base is minimal and balanced. And we also have some understated accessories, smooth blending of color, a tiny bit of intricacy for the added yin, and some understated waist emphasis as well for the slight understated yin undercurrent. So I would say this dress on Kirsten is a pretty good example of a soft classic dress. You can see that it's primarily simple. Her hair is neat with rounded edges, and the dress has some slight intricacy, slight yin detailing, but it's not over the top. It has some waist emphasis, and it has some intricacy on the skirt as well. So I think this is a really nice example of a soft classic dress. And of course, I'll give some more practical examples later. Let's talk about some soft classic challenges. So the first challenge is that soft classics can really look not very put together very easily. So you can see on the left, Kirsten is not looking too put together for some reason. And of course, that reason is because she's wearing some natural lines, which are the worst for any classic, is really natural lines. And you can see how, even though she probably put some effort into her look, she's wearing heels there on the left, she still doesn't really quite look put together, and she may not know exactly why that is. But as soon as her lines are more neat and more fitted, she could very well have put even less effort into the look in the middle than she did into the look in the previous set of images, but she looks so much more put together, and she looks much better because she is a soft classic, and she's all about very neat shapes, very smooth lines, and slight roundedness, but nothing too imbalanced, nothing too messy. So everything being very neat is a really important characteristic of soft classic. So the next thing I want to talk about is hair, and Kibbe says that hair is one of the most important things, and nothing can sort of ruin a look of a soft classic faster than unkempt hair. And you can see how on the right, Kirsten's hair is pretty neat, and I would say that she pulls off that overall look, and it's because her hair is neat and smooth and has some of those rounded edges, even though the rest of her look is just not very necessarily soft classic. So hair is so important. And the next challenge I want to talk about is that a classic body type is almost like a blank canvas. So whenever you put something else on it, it is going to look like definitely that's there. For example, on the left, you could say, wow, her shirt is definitely really loose. In the middle, you'd be like, of course, her outfit is definitely pretty teenagerish, pretty gamine-ish. And on the right, you could say, oh, I can see right away her jacket is a little bit too oversized. But this can also be a little bit of a benefit, because since soft classics don't lean too much yin or yang, then not that much can look separate from them because they have that balanced skeleton. And you can see that Kirsten on the left looks definitely overpowered by this soft gamine dress, but she doesn't look too separate from it. So if you know what you're doing, you can actually use this effect, which I'll talk about later, to create some more looks. And of course, when Julia Roberts Flamboyant Natural wears this soft gamine dress, it looks very separate from her, and her bones look large in contrast. But on Kirsten, it just looks like a very detailed, fun dress, but it doesn't necessarily look extremely, extremely separate from her. At the same time, soft classics are always, and classics in general, are always going to be the ladies who are getting compliments on their dresses, on their accessories, on their hair, because they are the ones who are overpowered. So you can see how on the left and in the middle, those looks, those dresses are really wearing Kirsten. So of course, she's going to get a compliment on the left. Okay, I love your dress. But in reality, of course, people are seeing the dress before they see her. And on the right, you can see how her beauty really comes out and she's not overpowered by her items. And the same can be said for Lupita on the left. Lupita, I love your earrings. Oh my gosh, they're so amazing. And of course, Lupita will wear the earrings again because she was told that they are amazing earrings, but they are overpowering her. And of course, they're great earrings, but they overpower her. And as soon as she puts on some more understated detailing, like on the right, I think that her beauty and her unique beauty and her balance really shows through with that yin undercurrent, and she just looks absolutely stunning there on the right. The world is full of classics and full of soft classics and dramatic classics who overdo it and have a look wear them, have their accessories wear them, or they simply look like they might be even trying a little bit too hard. Like you can see here, Marion on the right, it looks like she might be trying pretty hard to be very cool, very edgy. And as a contrast to this very edgy look, she actually can look a tiny bit boring. And on the left, you can see that this kind of very overtly sexualized look also looks like it's maybe extremely overt and more overt than it would look on a romantic. The world is also full of classics who look a little bit awkward or a little bit overt when they are overdoing the effect that they want to create. You can see how this same kind of posing with the very sexy look and the hand near the mouth looks much more overt on Marion than it does on Rachel McAdams, who is a theatrical romantic. And when we try to match the level of overtness, match the level of sexiness, you can see that for Marion, that look on the left, I would say she looks just as sexy as Rachel McAdams does on the right, but you can see how much more understated, how it doesn't take that much for Marion to already look quite sexy, quite sensual. She has a pretty simple dress. She has slightly sensual body language, but not too much, and a little bit goes a long way for Marion. And if Rachel did this kind of posing like Marion, Rachel would look elegant. She wouldn't even look like she is being a little bit sexy, maybe. So this is all about knowing the effects that your clothing and your lines have on you, and you can better achieve the kind of look that you are going for. Whether it's very overt or a little bit understated, doesn't matter. The point is that it's going to look very different on different body types. And of course, you can see Marion in these three images looking really quite sexy and also a little bit elegant, and she looks amazing. And you can see how her body language is very understated and her looks are pretty minimal detail and they have a touch of yin. So that is sort of a sexy look for a soft classic. And the same goes for Kirsten. You can see on the right, she looks a little bit dragged down by this overly glamorous look. And on the left and in the middle, she looks quite sexy and quite feminine and really very nice in my opinion. And it's all about realizing that understated things don't look understated on you as a classic. The same goes for a fun look, for an edgy look. So you can see how these three looks on these soft classics kind of look like they are wearing them, and the soft classic looks a little bit boring as a contrast to these very animated fun looks. And you can see that as soon as Marion puts on her own lines and she really honors her body type, she then looks sophisticated and interesting. I think she looks really quite artsy and sort of minimal on the left. And I would say the same can be said for Kirsten, especially on the left, where she really looks really quite interesting to me and pretty cool. But you can see something about the image on the left, and it's that it has some soft classic elements, like the softer sort of a neckline with some yin detailing on the shirt, but it also has some yang elements. So the vest and the pants are a bit more yang, so that gives her a bit of an edgy look. But at the same time, her hair is pretty neat, her makeup is balanced, and she doesn't have too much of this yang element, just a little tiny bit, just a drop of this yang element, and she already looks really quite edgy. So remember at the beginning of the video where I talked about one of the benefits of being a classic is that not that much will look separate from you. So you can use this to your advantage by including just one element, so it doesn't overpower you, but just one element from really any body type that you want, any body types lines that you want to create different looks, and this is the flexibility that you have as a classic specifically. Of course, other body types can do this too, but they are not going to do it as well as you do it because you are in the middle of the yin and yang spectrum. You can see that when Marion and Kirsten include other elements, so on the left, Marion has that sort of almost soft Gamine hair, but she looks really pretty interesting there. In the middle, she has the slight draped scarf, more of a natural type of scarf, but at the same time, her hair is very neat, her jacket fits pretty well, so she is only including one element. She already looks quite enigmatic there in the middle, and on the right, the same thing for Kirsten, she looks very enigmatic there with just one element, with her hair being neat, everything else being neat. And the same can be said for a little bit more of an edgy look. So you can see Kirsten, I guess she had some sort of a leather dress phase. I don't know if everyone had a leather dress phase or if it was just her, but I think these look quite edgy on her. They don't look over at the top, and I think they are simple. They are cut in a classic way, so they're not too short, too long. Their lines are pretty simple. The only thing about these looks that is not classic is the weight of the fabric. That is just one element. The fabric is thicker because it's leather, obviously. Of course, you don't have to wear leather to look edgy, but also you can see on the right, she is wearing a leather jacket and she looks very cool. Like if I saw her at some sort of restaurant or bar or lounge, like I would think she is pretty, pretty cool. So I think that that little bit of the one element goes a long way for a soft classic. Here we have the same thing. So we have a little bit of an understated tousled look with just some small rips on the jacket on Marion, and that already looks a little bit interesting, a little bit edgy maybe, and it doesn't take that much. And on the right, we have the same type of thing. And I would even say, you might think to yourself on the right, well, it's the belt that makes that look edgy. I don't think it's the belt. I think she could take the belt off or wear a thinner belt, which is recommended for soft classics. I think it's actually the neckline giving her that little bit of an edgy look, that high neckline. And imagine if she wasn't wearing the belt, she would still look really quite edgy with that makeup, that hair, and that high neckline dress, but still having some yin element to it with the lightweight fabric. And I was inspired by Kirsten's look here to create a look for you guys in the lookbook that I want to show you right now. So you can see it here that the dress has a higher neckline, but that's really the only thing that's not necessarily soft classic about it. Everything else is pretty minimal. It has a touch of yin around the neckline area. It's A-line, so that's pretty good. And the jewelry is minimal, but slightly intricate and slightly dainty. The shoes are tapered in, and the bag is medium-sized and pretty neat, and it doesn't have too many sharp edges, and the belt is a little bit delicate. And of course, you guys are classic, so you are always matching hardware. Everything matches, and that plays into your harmony. But at the same time, that higher neckline is going to be enough to look really quite edgy on you without looking over the top or like you're boring and trying too hard. It'll look just right on you and really very interesting. So thinking about that one element, so for example, here on the left, you can see that Kirsten looks very adorable, but everything about her dress is pretty simple. Her hair is pretty neat. Her makeup is balanced. Everything is pretty neat except for one thing, which is the polka dots, which already looks very fun, very cute, very girly on her. So you have to think of just one element that you want to include, and in the middle it's the same thing with Marion, with that slightly girly, slightly feminine hair, and she looks quite cute there. And on the right we have Naomi Watts, also soft classic, looking a little bit more fun with that horizontal stripe, even though of course her entire look aside from the horizontal stripe is soft classic. And you can see here when Kirsten wears more than one element of a different body type, like on the right, polka dots, high neckline, very tight and fitted and short, along with this very angular, thick fabric jacket. It looks maybe a little bit too much on her. It looks a little bit like she's fading into the background. around, and it doesn't look extremely separate, of course, because she's a classic, but it looks like she is fading into the background with this very animated look. And on the left, I think she really looks very adorable and fun, and on the right, she looks maybe a little bit more boring, ironically, on the right than she does on the left. So I was inspired to include two dresses with some polka dots for added fun or added cuteness, but these dresses still have a minimal base. So if the polka dots were gone, they would be purely soft classic or primarily soft classic dresses. And these two dresses are from the soft classic shopping page, so you could check them out. They would look quite cute. The one on the left would look pretty cute. The one on the right would look cute and maybe fun on you if that's what you're looking for. So another way that you can incorporate some other fun elements is thinking about color. So of course, this dress on the left is much more fun in yellow than it is on the right in black. So something as simple as color can really make a huge difference. So this dress, as well as all of the rest of the items that I'm going to show in terms of clothing, are all on the shopping page. So these are some examples of some dresses that you could wear. And you can see that they each have a pretty minimal base, but they have some added yin, either in terms of waist emphasis, some flowy fabrics, or some lightweight fabrics, sparkle, things like that. This dress is actually pretty similar to a dress that Naomi Watts, Soft Classic, wore once, and you can see how on Naomi that looks pretty good, but maybe those contrasting cuffs are too much, so I found a dress that doesn't have that contrast at the cuffs, and that would look really amazing on a Soft Classic. We've got the sheer fabric for the added yin, some understated waist emphasis on a minimal base, and it's really as simple as that. That would look really cool on a classic. For some shirts, you could do for very casual, again, a minimal base with some added yin. So on the left, we're adding yin with a bit of sparkle. In the middle, we're adding yin with that hem of the shirt and the hem on the sleeves being a little bit ruffly. And on the right is one of my favorite ways to add yin to a minimal base, which is this understated lace. And the rest of the shirt is really quite simple. So that would look amazing on a soft classic as well. For some more dressed up looks, the one on the left would look really a little bit edgy on a classic because of that high neckline, but that is the only element of edginess to it. So it's not going to look too separate from a soft classic. Everything else is a lightweight fabric, some slight fittedness, etc., and some sparkle. That's all going to look pretty harmonious on a soft classic. In the middle, we have a lightweight fabric, some understated waist emphasis, but really not overly draped. That would be a great shirt to wear to the office. And on the right, it's the same situation with some rounded edges, a lighter weight fabric, and that would look great for a business casual setting. So I also found this shirt here, which looks really quite similar to Kirsten's shirt on the left. And I think this would look really quite sexy on a soft classic without looking over the top or like you're necessarily trying too hard. Here are some examples of pants you could wear. Of course, they are all cropped at the ankle and they taper in at the ankle, and they are a bit of a lightweight fabric. They're also minimal detail, and my favorite pants out of these three are the ones in the middle, and they have some slight pleats, and the fabric is more lightweight, and it's not overly lightweight, and it's perfect for a soft classic. It really is a minimal base with added yin, and it would look absolutely great. Next up, we have skirts. So skirts are best when they are A-line or flowing, or if it's a straight skirt, it should taper in slightly. So you can see on the right, it's a straight skirt and it tapers slightly. And on the left, we also have a little bit of a sort of a pencil type of design, but it's not overly tight and it just tapers slightly and it has some of those yin ruffles at the bottom. And of course, in the middle is a little bit more of a dressed up skirt, but it has some yin detail with the flowy fabric, but at the same time, it's still A-line and pretty minimal. It's not over the top frilly. It doesn't have any contrasting hem or intense ruffles or anything like that. So that skirt is just the perfect soft classic skirt. And finally, we have blazers. So sweater blazers are amazing for a soft classic. If that's something that you feel like you could wear, the sweater blazer in the middle is really great because it doesn't have any sharp edges and it's a bit softer of a fabric. So that's going to pick up on the yin undercurrent, but still with a minimal base. And the ones on the left and right are both also good blazers because they don't have too much sharpness to them. And the one on the left even has a bit of yin detailing with those folds at the sleeves. So next up, we have hair. So soft classic hair is best when it's moderate to slightly long and it has a smooth outline with some rounded edges, but definitely not too glamorous or over the top. You could see there that Marianne Cotillard looks pretty good with this kind of soft classic hair. You can see on the left, when Marianne does not have this neat outline to the hair, it really kind of ruins her look and she doesn't really look like herself. And as soon as her hair is more neat, like in the middle, it doesn't even have to have rounded edges, but as soon as it's more neat, it already looks so much more harmonious with her, and of course even better on the right with some rounded edges and a smooth outline, but still primarily simple, is just ideal on Marianne. So she looks amazing there on the right, I think. But of course I also think there's some flexibility. Like, these two images of Marianne are not exactly the soft classic recommendation, but I still think she looks really, really wonderful in both of these and quite cute. And this is another example of that situation where you can add one element of another type. Maybe on the left, a bit more feminine, more theatrical romantic type hair, and on the right, maybe a bit more soft Gamines type of hair, but primarily still understated, never over the top. So that's the key, is if you want to bring in another element of another type, you want to make sure that it's understated, and that way it'll look absolutely amazing on you. And you can see when the other element in the hair that Marianne brings in is not understated, then it can look a little bit separate from her, or it can look not that great on her. Like on the left, primarily natural hair, in the middle primarily soft dramatic, and on the right primarily Gamines, and that looks a little bit too much on Marianne. So if you do bring in other elements, make sure that they're understated. So here's another example of Kirsten. Of course, Kirsten on the left looks amazing with her soft classic hair, but she brought in just a little bit of an element of natural on the right, but you can see that her hair is still neat. It's still not completely over the top, unconstructed, and messy, but it already looks messy on her, already looks a little bit casual on her. So that's the key, is just to bring in that little tiny element. So next up, we have makeup. So makeup is all about being blended and balanced. So here is Marianne looking absolutely stunning in some soft classic makeup. And it's definitely also about a balance of intensities between the eyes and the lips. And Kibbe even says in the main section of classic, in the makeup portion, that the eyes and the lips on a classic look best when they are of the same intensity. So that is bold eyes, bold lips, or understated eyes and understated lips. If you guys remember in my soft Gamines video, I gave this example of Marianne to show that soft Gamines really don't look that great when their eyes and lips are of the same intensity, but classics look really great when their eyes and lips are of the same intensity. And you can see here Sarah Hyland on the right, and how even though she has her soft Gamines hair, she has her soft Gamines high neckline, and she has her soft Gamines bright colored makeup, when she has the same color, the same intensity of color on her eyes and on her lips, it looks a little tiny bit tiring on her. And on the other hand, when Marianne does something like this, it looks just right, because Marianne's face is primarily balanced. So we want to echo that balance in the makeup as well, and have the same intensity eyes and lips. And you can see when Marianne has only the eyes being very dramatic and bold and the lips being a little bit more understated, you almost just, you want to put some lipstick on her to balance her eyes, because her lips look a little bit naked and her face is out of balance, because she is a balanced type. She is classic, but Sarah Hyland on the right is a mixture of opposites. So that kind of mixture of very intense eyes and subdued lips looks really great on her. I don't have this urge to put lipstick on her, right? And the same goes the other way around. You can see it, Jenna, soft Gamines, and again, Marianne having this red lip with not that much eye makeup and not that much blush, and you can see how it throws off Marianne's face. But on the other hand, on Jenna, it looks just right. It looks really quite fresh. So it's really all about balance. Whatever you choose to do, if you choose to go for a more understated look, like on the left, that looks so elegant and so amazing on Marianne, and the balance is between the intensity of the eyes and the intensity of the lips, and the same on the right with a more bold look. Makeup should also be blended and not have that many harsh or sharp lines or angles. You can see in the middle and on the right, that kind of winged liner is a little bit separate from Marion, but as soon as she blends it like on the left, that looks so much better and so much more harmonious with her yin flesh. A glossy lip is also a little bit better than a matte lip. You can see how on the right, the matte kind of drags down her face a little bit, and on the left, that kind of glossy lip looks a lot more fresh on Marion. But I noticed that you certainly don't have to overdo the gloss on your lip if you don't want to, although if you want to do a glossy lip, it would also look amazing. You can just go for a moisturized lip, something that has a little tiny bit of a sheen like in these two images, and that already is going to look amazing. Next up, we have handbags, so they should be primarily simple and not have any harsh edges or geometrics and be made of some supple leather, some softer fabrics maybe, and be moderate to small sized. But of course, it's real life, so sometimes we need a larger bag. So in my opinion, if you need a larger bag, you could go for something like on the right that has a little bit more dainty elements, like the handle is a bit more dainty and the shapes are not very sharp. For jewelry, understated with a touch of interest, intricacy is the way to go, and your jewelry should be used to complete your look. For example, if you're wearing a very elegant dress and it's kind of, you know, people would want to think that you just would have earrings on with this dress, then that is when you put on these earrings. So you want to complete the look and have the jewelry play into the entire overall look. And of course, you want to match your jewelry together. And these kinds of understated looks are the way to go. For shoes, we have some slightly bare look for sandals and also some delicate flats. So either some delicate tapering at the toe, like the two on the right, or really some simple flats that are not over the top and sort of show the foot a little bit more. That would look amazing. And also, Kibbe says that a light leg, that is a lighter colored shoe and lighter colored maybe stockings, are a really elegant look on soft classics. So that is it, you guys. It has been such a long video. So thank you for watching all the way till the end. You should check out the shopping pages, check out the lookbook, and let me know what you think. Let me know if you have any questions or video requests. I'd love to hear them. All right, I'll talk to you next time.